welcome to another exciting lecture of Mech Easy. Our today's topic is centrifugal casting. Alright, so this is the classification of centrifugal casting. There are three types: true centrifugal casting, semi-centrifugal casting, and centrifuge casting. Now, there are two more subdivisions in the true centrifugal casting, that is horizontal axis and vertical axis. Semi-centrifugal casting and centrifuge casting will cover in the next lectures. In today's lecture, we'll only talk about true centrifugal casting and we'll see the subtypes. Alright, so this is a setup for true centrifugal casting for horizontal axis. As you can see, we have a motor over here which is connected to these rollers. These are the top rollers and these are the bottom rollers. And we have our metallic mold over here which is coated with ceramic. We always coat a metallic mold with ceramic so that the molten metal which enters the mold doesn't stick to the walls of the mold. A mold is usually kept rotating at a high RPM of about 3000, and then while it is rotating, this molten metal is poured into the pouring basin. As soon as it enters the mold, it is subjected to centrifugal force, and depending on the density, the alloying components are deposited towards the wall and towards the center. Now, those having high density are deposited towards the wall, and those with lower density are deposited towards the center. Some impurities with lighter density are also deposited towards the center, which are then removed during the finishing process. Now, the mold is kept rotating till the molten metal solidifies. After solidification, the casting is extracted. So this was all about the true centrifugal casting for horizontal axis. Now let's see it for vertical axis. So this is a setup for true centrifugal casting for vertical axis. As you can see, this is our rotating die. This is our rotating table. This is the electric motor which is fastened to the rotating table, and this is a power supply. The principle being the same, the molten metal enters the rotating die through this pouring basin, and as soon as it enters, it is subjected to the centrifugal force and the particles are deposited towards the wall. The die is kept rotating until and unless the metal solidifies, and once the metal is solidified, the casting is extracted. So that's all about the vertical axis arrangement. Now let's quickly head towards the advantages. Now these are the advantages of true centrifugal casting. It provides flexibility. Now how does it provide flexibility? Suppose we are producing a hollow job and the thickness of which is to be varied. So depending on the thickness requirements, we vary the amount of molten metal which is to be poured into the metallic mold. Next, unlike investment casting, very, very large items can be produced through centrifugal casting. In sand casting, whenever we want to produce a hollow job, we make use of core. Now, over here, this core is not required because centrifugal force comes into picture and we get hollow components. Similarly, even gates and risers are not required in this process. Next, the impurities which get settled towards the center are of lighter density and can be removed easily. Also, the production cost is very less for this process. So that's all for the advantages. Let's head towards the disadvantages. So these are the disadvantages. In true centrifugal casting, we can only produce jobs which are symmetrical. We cannot produce asymmetrical jobs. Next, the segregation of alloying components is more in this process. Like I said, due to the centrifugal force, the alloying components get segregated depending on the density. Machining of internal diameter is required because the impurities which get settled towards the center are to be removed. Then this process requires very high investment because the setup required for this process is very costly. Skilled labors are required for this process, and the internal diameter is always inaccurate in dimensions. And this process requires longer lead time, that's why it is very time consuming process. So these are the applications. This process is generally used to produce hollow components such as pipes, bearings, nozzles, IC engine liners, etc. And these are the diameter, length and weight specifications for this particular process. Parts of diameter within the range of 0.25 to 3 meter can be produced. Length up to 15 meter and weight up to 5 tons can be produced. So that's it guys. We are wrapping today's lecture till here. In the next two lectures, we'll talk about semi-centrifugal casting and centrifuge casting. And if you have any queries regarding this lecture, please make sure that you comment below in the comment section. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything. See you in the next video, guys. Bye.